Palo Alto Networks is the cybersecurity vendor of choice for nearly 100,000 organizations worldwide, protecting hundreds of millions of people. This makes us a top target for cyber attacks. My name is Peter Havens, and I welcome you to join us in this discovery series where we will explore how Palo Alto Networks Security Operations Center is protecting our company and our people and learn how we do it.
And we are back with another episode of This Is How We Do It, a series where we're looking at how the Security Operations Center team at Palo Alto Networks uses the people, process, and technologies to keep us safe from cybersecurity attacks. In this session, we'll talk about specifically threat hunting and the practice of threat hunting. And joining me today is Leeroy Pereira, a staff security engineer as a part of our SOC. Leeroy, thank you for joining me.
Thank you very much. I'm very excited to be here.
Yeah, it's great to have you. And you're specifically responsible for the practice of threat hunting. You lead threat hunting in the Palo Alto Networks SOC, correct?
Yes, I do.
Okay, wonderful. Well, good to have you.
Thank you.
Can you just tell us, let's start by defining or understanding, why do we need threat hunting at Palo Alto Network? Can't we just rely on the threat detection and response products to do and identify all threats and prevent them?
Well, not necessarily. So hunting is a complementary task that is coming in and trying to look at something that is business specific and not go and look at the detections that are already brought into all of the customers. We are trying to look at what is going on in Palo Alto Networks and being very specific to what Palo Alto Networks needs and what the SOC needs to alert on.
Okay, so the threat detection and response platform, in our case, XSIAM or XDR, is responsible for threat detection generically for all customers. And you are specifically creating these threat hunts that are tailored towards the specific business concerns for Palo Alto Networks.
Yes.
Yes?
That's true.
Okay. Okay. So you're really defining these things in a way that's unique to us. There's other forms of threat hunting. We have a threat hunting service that we call Managed Threat Hunting that our Unit 42 folks do. And that's more looking at threat hunts in the form of late-breaking threat activity and adversarial activity that might be new. And we're a customer of that. So they focus on, you know, what are the latest threats, what are the latest threat actors, and how do we ensure that they are not active in your environment? And you're more specifically looking at the business-specific criteria for Palo Alto Networks.
Yeah, so what we as a business needs and what we need to find and go and hunt for, and very specific to that.
Okay.
The MTH service is giving us that services, but they are doing it on a broadened level. So they're looking at the adversary in a different way.
Okay.
Techniques that they are utilizing.
Right, right. So they're the experts in the adversaries and the latest techniques, and you are more focused on being an expert of Palo Alto Networks and their specific business needs and concerns.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Yeah. Okay, so we know why we threat hunt. Let's talk about this term, threat hunt. What is it? What does it look like? How do you develop a threat hunt, if you will?
Yeah, so a threat hunt is an hypothesis.
Okay.
It's basically a theory that we come and we try to take an idea or something that is occurring in our environment and try to see if we can branch out of it and try to catch sub-theories within it in order to understand if that is something we need to react on.
Okay.
So, or proactively react on, right? And then we take that data and eventually we end up with a query.
Okay, so it's an idea that you formulate in your head about maybe malicious activity within the company?
Yeah.
Okay, and you formulate that into, you said, a query?
Yeah.
Right? Okay, so so how do you do that? How do you do that with Cortex?
Yeah, so in Cortex, we actually use the query language, SQL.
Okay.
And the SQL language lets us utilize all the data set that we already ingest into the system. And as those data sets are giving us a lot of information, a lot of data. So we can utilize each of them. So we can use a lot of mechanism for deduping, for exclusion, and we can also take the data sets themselves and start deducting the data.
Okay, so in a previous session, we talked with Isaac Kay from our SOC team, who's responsible for all the data ingestion and data pipelining within the Palo Alto Networks SOC, and we know from that session that we bring everything into Cortex XDR, all XSIAM, into the data lake. You have all of the firewall endpoint network, identity, everything in one place. So you have this rich data set at your disposal.
Yes, it's a full business suit.
Yeah.
Full Palo Alto, so that is why I like having the one vendor umbrella.
Okay, so you can create these pretty rich queries, these hypotheses, And then it just works. You create a query in your head, you turn it into SQL, and it's just magic, and you get threats, yes?
Not that simple, but okay. Yeah, so...
How does it work?
Yeah, we take an idea, mm-hmm. and then we use a lot of mechanism where it is, as I said before, exclusion and deduping, right?
Okay.
But then we
because
also...
Because your initial query generates a lot of results, or...?
Yeah, so the results themselves in the traditional hypothesis is too big.
Okay.
So it's too large, and you cannot use that information in an effective way.
Too much data?
Yes.
Okay.
So we need to refine it okay. and take that data to a level where we can actually take this and give it to the analyst to start
with. How do you refine that data? How do you refine that query?
So a lot of deduping and traditional stuff like exclusion, mm-hmm. but also joining a lot of the data. A lot of the data sets and try to see what works in your environment. So you have to know your environment. You okay. have to actually understand what is actually going on in my environment and how are the users are using my environment okay. in order to understand how better a threat actor could use my environment.
Okay, so you're joining data sets to help you refine the result into something that more richly contains threats, is that right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So at the end, we get a shrinked data set.
Okay.
And that data set is already full with a lot of, I would say, good stuff.
Okay, right? Good stuff.
So a lot
so
of threats.
Potential threats, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so this is when you've refined that threat hunt into a query that produces a data set that's richer. Now it's something that can be analyzed by a human, I assume?
Yeah.
Okay.
So eventually we take those threats and then we cut them down, right? Mm-hmm. into manageable chunks,
okay.
and then we take that and give that to the analysts. The analysts
okay.
are walking those tickets
okay.
and are actually performing their task in order okay. to okay. get a report at the end.
So your job is to create these theories, these hypotheses,
yes.
refine those into something that produces a rich data set, and when you've got that, you hand that off to the security analyst to go and pursue those potential threats?
Yes.
Ah, okay. So they probably love you. You're feeding them with rich data sets to actually go and find real potential malicious activity within the company. Yes?
Actually, that's true because it is a very heavy task. Mm-hmm. It's a very hard task. You have to take a lot of things into consideration.
Mm-hmm.
And then when you get something very specific, you know that you're probably going to get something. So,
right, right. Yeah. So if we were just to summarize, the product, yeah. Cortex XSIAM or XDR, is responsible for generically doing threat detection and response. And you're responsible for creating these theories, these queries, these threat hunts
yeah.
that are going to complement that with maybe specific concerns or business threats that are specific to Palo Alto Networks.
Yeah.
Yes?
Yes.
Okay, good. So once you've created these threats, these threat hunts that are producing valuable information, you've handed them to the security analysts, what then? Do they become part of an ongoing process that you run regularly, or how does that work?
Yeah, so at the very end, mm-hmm. those things are staying in our hunting pools, mm-hmm. right?